لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. We asked a question last night and we expect the answers today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared war against two types of people. One of them mentioned in the Quran, specifically in Surah Al-Baqarah, and the other one is mentioned in the Sunnah, Hadith Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who spoke in this hadith, but it is in the books of Sunnah, inshaAllah. So we have two prizes here for the two who will answer the first and the second. Okay, just raise hands so we'll see the friendly faces. We're gonna, okay, one, two. Who else? Three. Five is four. Abbas, five. Who else? Okay, Abu Abdullah, six. That's number. And what's your name, brother? Huh? Harun? Harun, number seven. Can we go with Harun, please? It's, you know, he looks very friendly. Go ahead, Harun. What is number one? Just take an interest? Yes. So if you pay it, it's okay. So we could say dealing in interest. He's involved in interest. Takbir! That is number one, mashallah. That is correct. The answer is right. So the person who's engaging in interest, can you name the verse for us? Can you name the verse for us? The verse number. I'm still going to give you a prize, inshallah. Okay. So the first one is certainly interest. Can I ask that question? Why interest, ya ikhwah? I mean, that word interest still a deception, a form of deception. But the real name is what? No, in English, what is the real name? And it's mentioned in the Old Testament. Usury. Usury. So that word interest is very deceiving, and it's one of the tricks of shaitan to name things with deceiving names. So nudity is called what? Fashion. Music and is called art. You know, so that's, you know, that's how he goes about it. The question here, should we ask why usury is haram? Should we ask that question? Can we? Why did Allah make usury haram? Can we? Normally, ya ikhwa, the religion is beliefs, the foundation. We call it aqidah sometimes. We call it tawheed. Two, ibadat, acts of worship. Three, akhlaq, character, having a good character. Four, mu'amalat, transactions, contracts. How to trade, how to marry. And number six, which is really a minor portion of the religion, which is the penal code, which is al-hudud al-shar'iyya, al-lawa al-qatta' al-shari'a. It's a very small number of. So once it comes to one and two and three, no point to ask, because you never know. You cannot use your intellect. And Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu made a very profound statement in this regard. He said, لو كان الدين بالعقل, if the religion is based on intellect, wiping over the, you know, the bottom of your sock, the leather socks, would make more sense than wiping what? Where do you wipe when you do wiping? On the top. Then wiping should be where? So there is no intellect in these commands. You just have to say سمعنا وأطعنا. Do you know why you place your right and your left? Do you? Why just two sajda, not five, not four? Allah designed it this way, don't ask. But once it comes to business transactions, to mu'amalat, yes. Actually, analogy and knowing the objective behind it is a key. Now, the question here, why usury is haram? So we could say why usury is haram. Because we need to understand the purpose behind it. Why? Anyone who answers that question will give him an extra prize. Yes. That's very nice, but I want you to dig deeper. But this is the result of usury. It's correct, 100%. I'll give you a prize, man. I mean, you're making me guilty. I'll give you one. But it just, there is a deeper meaning out there. Yes. Okay, just you saying وَأَحَلَّ اللَّهُ الْبَيْعَ وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَى, you know what it means. But, okay. Ya ikhwa, the danger of usury, that you turn money into a commodity. Money is supposed to turn economy up in the society. If I have $100,000, I don't have it, wallahi. Wallahi, I don't. Hypothetical. But if I do have $100,000, now, if I give it to you and receive it $150,000, what did I do? I know, but what did I do? I turned money into a commodity. But if you do not do this, and it's haram to do this, what I have to do to invest that amount? I go and buy a piece of land. So I'm going to benefit another Muslim. I'm going to give him the land price. Okay, I want to build a house on that land. I'm going to hire a builder. He's going to come and build. He's going to get some of that money. And I'm going to need electricity, electrician. I'm going to need, so I'm going to get the society what? Economy going. Everybody will benefit from that 100,000. But when you give it 100,000 and take it, who benefited? Just me. And I took advantage, like our brother said, of the person who paid the amount. And that is why usury is a form of injustice. And that is why Allah doesn't like it. It's a form of injustice in a way that you're doing injustice to the society. And we live here in a very capitalistic society. When the inflation rate goes up, and they want to bring it down, and they want to move up the economy a little bit, what is the first thing that you hear them doing? Lower what? So the money would do what? More what? Productivity in the society. And that is the wisdom why. It's a form of injustice, and Allah doesn't like it. And that is why Allah declares war against the individual who gets involved in it. لَعَنَ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى. Look at this. Allah curses usury. Look, وَآكِلَهُ, the one who receives it. وَمُوكِلَهُ, the one who feeds it. وَكَاتِبَهُ, the one who writes the contract. وَشَاهِدَيْهِ, and the two who witness on that contract. Look at this now. كُلُّهُمْ سَوَاء. All of them are equal, equally guilty in that particular crime. فَنَسْأَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِخْوَةً, أَنْ يُحَرِّرَنَا مِنْ هَذَا الذَّنْبِ. يعني is one, and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw the one who he devours usury swimming in a sea of blood. That's his punishment in the grave. Do you know why? Why blood? Because he sucked the blood of people in this world. He sucked their blood. You know, somebody who's in need, he needs your help, man. Your brother needs your help. Give him something, give him a goodly loan for the sake of Allah, and he will get rewarded for it. Okay, for the sake of time here, two more minutes, inshallah. The second, okay, I promise to give you a... Okay. You know, the brother in the back really deserves a very good prize as well. Okay, yeah, you, inshallah. Yes, I think you got the answer, but you were running around. The fact that you said, وَأَحَلَّ اللَّهُ الْبَيْعَ وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَى, that's the answer, that's the evidence. Okay, where is the second situation Allah declares war against him? Anyone knows in the Sunnah? You got a prize already tonight.
His brother right here. He's coming twice.
I don't know what he is. We'll meet you up tomorrow, right? This brother. Is that your first time?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
The one who worships idols?
The one who worships idols? It's very correct, but not the one. This one in hell. Okay. Okay, what is your name? What is your name, by the way? Laif. Lion. All right. أحسنت. من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Whoever has animosity against the friend of Allah, ولي الله, the friend of Allah, Allah will declare war against that person. But now, that is being abused. In that hadith, Allah tells you, how do you become waliullah? The rest of the hadith actually explains it. How? What is the curriculum to become waliullah? Look. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَطُّهُ عَلَيْهِ. My slave will not find something dearer to me, which will bring him closer to me than when I made mandatory upon him. So you have to fulfill what? The commands of Allah. Because our dear al-wali, he will like, I don't have to pray. And I'm above that. الصَّلَاةَ هَذِهِ وَالْحَجَاتَ هَذِهِ for the فِي الْعَوَامِ أَنَا خَوَاسُ الْخَوَاسِ. I'm a special one. I don't have to pray. We use the manipulate this verse at the end of Surah Al-Hijj. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship your Lord until you reach certainty. They say, I reach already certainty. Even though the word certainty was explained في السنة, that is death. Another verse which explains the manhaj al-wilaya, ikhwa. أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Indeed, the friends of Allah, they shall not fear nor grieve. Who are those? What is the next verse? What? الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. They have iman and taqwa. نَسْأَ اللَّهَ أَنْ نَكُونَ مِنْهُمْ يَا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. جزاك الله خيرا. What is the name?
مُثَنَّى. Two.
All
right. Only Iraq can name these names. Only Iraq can name. Light. I'm sure light from Iraq too. Surya. Okay. Very close. جزاك الله خيرا. جزاك الله خيرا.
The young brothers in the back, we have a baby sitting out there. If you're too much to be here, you cannot be back there and make a noise, please. We have prepared the place for you. This place is for the brothers who pray quietly with serenity. Don't be like shaitan, even though shaitan is chained. If you feel like you want to play and have a good time, just go to the daycare or to the sport court. This place is designated for you, inshallah.